everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing what my baby eats in a day as well as her schedule. She is sleeping through the night and she just turned 8 months old today while I'm recording this video. So she usually nurses around 6:45. The latest I will let her sleep is 7:30 before I wake her up. So she nurses and daddy burps her and we all just kind of lounge in bed while we have our coffee. After we're done our coffee, we head downstairs and Ella has a little snack. She has some puffs while she waits for her breakfast to cook. This girl loves to eat, as you will see in this video. So one of my favorite baby morning breakfasts is this organic oatmeal banana pancake. So all you do is do 2 tablespoons of oatmeal and 1/2 of a ripe banana and 1 egg yolk. As per her pediatrician, she does not want her to have egg whites yet, and the yolk is so good for brain development and DHA, so that is why I make her pancake this way. So all you do is mix those 3 ingredients together, super easy, super healthy. I just smash it up with a fork and then kind of stir it together, and then I cook it on a hot frying pan. You only need to flip these pancakes once. They do need to kind of sit there for a minute. Until you see it starting to brown around the edges, and then just flip them over. For those of you who are new to our channel, Ella is my third baby. I have 2 boys, one is 3 years old. One is 2 years old. So I've had experience with feeding babies before, so I'm very comfortable with this. I don't believe that you have to do one or the other when it comes to purees or baby-led weaning. I like to do a mix of both. So there's mornings where she has her oatmeal with just a little bit of breast milk and peanut butter mixed in, and I feed her. She has yogurt and I feed her, but there's other things that I like to give her, and she's really getting really good at eating. She usually doesn't miss her mouth. So you'll see throughout the video, when she first gets food on her plate or on her tray, she kind of feels it and looks at it, and that's so normal. Also, what is normal is a little bit of gagging. The baby is not choking. You need to know the difference between gagging and choking. Everybody gags. That's how babies learn how to eat. Of course, just look at baby-led weaning, do your own research. I'm not saying that's the best way to go. It's just the way that I feed my babies, and my kids are really great eaters when it comes to feeding themselves and things like that. I will start to give her utensils pretty soon just to kind of mess with, but yeah, do your research. After this, it's playtime around 8:30. Again, this isn't like a strict, when it comes to 8:30, that this is like she needs to play. It's just like a little bit after she has finished eating. And my baby girl loves to dance. Any kind of music she hears, she is dancing. So again, you'll also see her dancing throughout this video. Now a little bit of peekaboo. At 9 a.m., no matter what time she wakes up, 9 a.m. is her first nap. So I put her in a sleep sack every single time. I also have blackout curtains in her room and a sound machine that plays white noise. And in the beginning of her sleep session, I play the baby shusher. So that kind of goes off on itself after about 20 minutes or so. She woke up from her first nap at 10:30. That's kind of normal for her. She'll take anywhere from an hour nap to an hour and a half nap. Now she's getting dressed for the day. I like to get her dressed after breakfast just because she makes such a mess with breakfast and I don't want to ruin her outfit. Now she is on nursing session number 2. This is not always at 10:45. Nursing session number 2 comes after she wakes up from her first nap. And you can see I just left that part in here because at 8 months old, we're kind of having a hard time with her staying latched because she's so nosy and gets so distracted. So any of my nursing mamas out there, I'm sure you can relate to that. Your babies get nosy and kind of look around. After playtime is over, I'm giving her some lunch. She loves avocado. With all of my kids, avocado was the first food that I introduced, and I feel like it was really worked out great for me. So she's going to be having some avocado, some shredded cheese, and some baby yogurt. She absolutely loves avocado and she really loves cheese. I keep the pieces this big for her to kind of smush up in her hand and eat them herself. However, I know some moms that will crush up Cheerios and rub the avocado in Cheerios so that the baby can pick it up better. I actually put some of her cheese on it sometimes and that helps her pick it up better as well. But yes, she does really good with this. Now I'm just going to go ahead and feed her yogurt. And I can kind of see her cues. She does not eat that entire thing of yogurt almost ever. She usually eats about half of it per sitting. You can kind of tell when they start to get full. They won't open their mouth anymore and will just seem disinterested. I've also started giving her some water with her meal times. She's still getting the hang of using a sippy cup, so we're kind of just letting her practice at this point. Now it is time for her second nap. Her second nap is always at 1 p.m. no matter what. I am still working on lengthening her second nap. I have worked with Mahalia Patel and she helped me get Ella on a really good schedule. I totally recommend her. I'll have her information linked below, but her second nap should be longer, but she usually winds up only taking an hour nap for her second nap. And when this happens, I try to put her down for a cat nap at 3:30. So at 2:10, she's having her third nursing session. Again, this is just whenever she wakes up from her second nap. And she's gonna go ahead and play some more. Around 3:15, she's having another little snack. This is just anywhere in between her dinner time. She has a snack in between dinner time. Today, she's having these little teething cookies. She loves these. This was also one of the first foods that she had as well. I'm trying her for another nap at 3:30. Like I said, when she wakes up early, I try for a third nap at 3:30, but my goal is for her to just have two really good naps at 8 months old. That's usually what's recommended. At 4:01, she still did not fall asleep, so I went in and got her, and now we're just gonna have a little playtime and enjoy these baby giggles.
You're a silly girl. You're so sleepy. Huh? You're the best. Put the key.
5 p.m. is always dinner in our house. So sometimes the kids, the boys, will eat anywhere between like 5 p.m. and 6 p.m., but Ella always eats at 5. So she is having some blueberries to start. I do smush them in between my fingers just slightly. I don't leave them perfectly round. It's just my personal preference, and I always do it like that. She is having leftovers for dinner. The night before, I had made ground turkey with some chopped up sweet potatoes, and she loves ground turkey. It's one of her favorites. I totally recommend it for your babies. You can just see how happy she is when she eats it. She likes sweet potatoes, but she loves ground turkey. You can see here she always signs for more when she really loves something. So that's what she's doing when she's putting her hands together like this. Since she did not take that third nap, I'm getting her stuff for her bath ready, and she will be going to sleep extra early. I do the same thing with my boys as well. If they don't take a good nap, they go to bed early, because according to the sleep consultant, no matter what their naps are like, they still need the same amount of sleep. So if my kids don't take a good nap, they go to bed earlier and they still wake up at the same time.
So sweet.
Now after bath, we're just reading a book together before I nurse her and put her to sleep. The boys right now, the reason why they're not home is because it's my husband's early night and he took them to the trampoline park. So when my husband is here, this schedule works out perfectly. When he is not home, when he works late, our schedule looks a little bit different than this. The same times on everything, but just looks different because it's a little bit more chaotic with the boys. So Ella is asleep by 6:15, and she slept through the night and woke up at, I had to actually wake her up at 7:30 the next morning. I hope that you all enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up.